In the day's other news, U.S. Special Forces have captured the Islamic State's chemical weapons chief in northern Iraq. The Associated Press reports he was taken in a raid last month. The report also says follow-up airstrikes have hit Islamic State chemical facilities in recent days.
And in Somalia, there is word that U.S. and Somali forces killed 10 Al-Shabaab militants in an overnight raid. Somali intelligence officials say the target was a town controlled by the group west of Mogadishu. This comes 3 days after U.S. airstrikes hit an Al-Shabaab camp. The Pentagon said up to 150 fighters were killed there, but the militants disputed that figure.
For the first time, a Japanese court has ordered a nuclear reactor shut down over safety concerns. Another one already down will have to stay offline. The court ruled the reactors near Kyoto have not been adequately upgraded since the Fukushima disaster. But the Japanese government disputed the finding.
An independent regulatory committee, including professionals and architects, spent a lot of time to come up with the decision that the reactors are up to top world-level standards. The government backs the decision and has not changed its stance on restarting the reactors.
Japan shut down all of its nuclear power plants after a tsunami severely damaged the Fukushima plant 5 years ago this week. The government has now begun slowly restarting some of the plants.
Tributes came in from around the music world today for George Martin, the legendary record producer of the Beatles. He gave the group their first break in 1962 and guided them through the next decade as they revolutionized pop music. Beatles biographer Philip Norman spoke to Independent Television News today.
He was a musician as well as a producer. He saw the real talent in John Lennon and Paul McCartney, and he really devoted himself to sort of making it sound as good as it could. He became a celebrity producer, although he didn't want to be a celebrity.
George Martin was 90 years old.
Back in this country, a period of official mourning began for former First Lady Nancy Reagan, who died Sunday at the age of 94. Mrs. Reagan's casket was brought to her husband's presidential library in Simi Valley, California, where the public viewing began. She will lie in repose until the funeral set for Friday.
Wall Street managed modest gains today. The Dow Jones Industrial Average was up 36 points to close at 17,000. The NASDAQ rose 25 points, and the S&P 500 added 10.
And score another breakthrough for artificial intelligence. A computer program designed by Google has beaten one of the world's top players in Go, the ancient Chinese board game. The computer relayed moves to a human stand-in as it squared off against the 18-time world champion in South Korea. Afterward, he praised the program. The game involves roughly 200 possible moves per turn, compared to 20 in chess.